the previous runs and knowing you're just going to have to eke out another couple of tens and knowing that you have to go considerably quicker. And that's the way I went into that run. And it was a little uncomfortable going to...
But could win races.
And the fellow in the white shirt is still going to be at the head of it all.
Ah, well, let's see. Let's see.
Thanks, buddy.
Thank you.
He'll go when he wants to, Tony. But just give us your view on things. You keep your ear very close to the ground in this sport.
Well, I think the manufacturers have poured millions in themselves and they've gone, hey, what about me? We need something back about this. In order to stay in longer, they get something back. They can justify it to their own boards as well. But the team owners and the team managers think, well, hang on, the manufacturers come and the manufacturers go. We still have to run Formula One. That's why.
But Tony there mentioning some of the team's views. Let's hear some of those views, shall we? First of all, talking to Sir Frank Williams, the team boss of BMW Williams.
It must be clear that the Concorde Agreement
and Martin ducking.
Truly epic races, as well as Formula One's most tragic weekend. The first San Marino Grand Prix was held in 1981, but a year later, Imola was the scene of bitter political confrontation as 26. position. That's Jarno Trulli. So, two dramatic changes right at the start of the San Marino. Yeah, and that's proven, Martin, by the fact that Barrichello is now up the road. Look at the gap as they go up towards the Pirotella on lap 9 out of 62. And now Michael is having a look. And Olivier just shuts the door right and left at the Varianta Alta, the highest point of the course. Drop downhill. Michael's going for it.
Yes, Michael, I think, will pull the same move. Will he? Will Panis go to block him? No, he can't. He's not. I think he's too busy fighting himself, Panis, to get too heavy with the current World Championship leader.
Getting a few smiles now from the crowd. Barrichello is in the points, sixth position, 2.1 seconds behind Montoya. His last lap was marginally slower, but then he didn't have a clear track. Now he has, and he's going for it. And Ralf Schumacher has just made the fastest lap of the race, 1 minute 27.554, compared with the lap record of 1:27.5. So he's just 0.2 of a second off Frentzen's all-time lap record here on this circuit, 1:25.5 in the Williams.
Yes, it's a 25.5 then is the outright lap record. But Coulthard in second and Ralf Schumacher in first. They are just leagues ahead of anybody else in lap time. They're just about 2 seconds a lap faster now than this man truly. And Hakkinen then is getting held up at a similar pace. So Schumacher, Ralf that is, and David Coulthard waltzing away with a 12-second gap up front.
way back into Formula One, feeling their way back very successfully, I might say, because this is the fourth race of the year out of 17. BMW power and the tyres that he's got, and his own. He is seemingly on his way to a debut victory in Formula One. But in order to do that, he's got to do another 40 laps into the pit lane. Comes Tasso Marquez. He has not retired, as you can see, in the European Minardi.
Either Ralf Schumacher or Montoya, either of them could have and would have won the race. So I'm absolutely sure that
for the lead. Goes by, that's Tasso Marquez. So now Michael Schumacher is running last, 19th and last. Retirements from Kimi Raikkonen, Jos Verstappen and Fernando Alonso. I think it's...
for his Grand Prix career, hasn't won since he was Montoya cruising. So Montoya then with some other problems. Normally the car will change gear absolutely fine without a clutch. You need it for the start and you need it for the pit stops.
Well, there's one man with a smile on his face as a result of that, and that is Eddie Jordan, because now as Montoya really does cruise, and you see Luciano Berti in the Jaguar, and we've got more news from James Allen,
who is being hustled out of the Williams garage because they're making a space for the car of Juan Pablo Montoya. I think he's going to retire from this motor race, guys. Really bad luck. It's the most eerie thing, though, when an engine dies in the pit lane. Everybody's standing around trying to get it starting again, and the frustration was intense, but it was only mitigated by the fact that they've got another car in the lead. A lot of excitement still at Williams.
Well, Berti is having an enormous battle with Jean Alesi in the Prost. Berti in the green Jaguar. He's just been passed. He's had to let Häkkinen pass to lap him and try to keep Alesi behind him at the same time. They're battling for 10th position, and Berti has got it. His teammate Eddie Irvine is out of the race. That is Olivier Panis, who was in 8th position, getting a shove out, but it was only helping him. He was not in the same situation that Montoya was in. We're on lap 50, and as you watch the Berti Alesi Jaguar Prost battle as they come up to go through, no, Panis keeps them back because he's fighting for position on the track. Lap 50, race. Coulthard in in a dominant style is that man, Ralf Schumacher from Hoyer. that Damon Hill rightly could win the race. Are crowding the pit lane to look over that safety glass. There is Patrick Head will be coming out, and Ralf Schumacher from Germany, the brother of Michael, is going to make his parents very, very happy indeed as he drops down the hill to Williams are back. BMW are winning their fourth, their first race since they returned to Formula One. Four
they all worked hard as everybody else does, and Ralf triumphed magnificently today. He had it well under control all of the time.
It was a stunning performance from Ralf, wasn't it?
He's a winner. He's obviously
Yes, something wrong.